Can you press a switch without making any physical contact? Of course you can. There are actually a few ways to do so. One of them is to use your psychic powers or the force. However, the more common one is to use a Hall sensor, a device that converts the energy stored in a magnetic field into an electric signal using the Hall effect. The Hall effect was discovered in 1879 by Mr. Edwin Hall while he was exploring the interactions between magnets and electric currents. He observed that when a golden rectangular sheet conducting current is placed into a magnetic field, a difference in electric potential appears on the opposite edges. In other words, when a current conducting material is placed into a magnetic field, a voltage will be generated perpendicular to both the current and the field. The Hall voltage is proportional to the vector cross product of the current and the magnetic field, and therefore the highest value is when the sensor is perpendicular to the current. The basic Hall effect sensor contains the Hall element, a regulator, and an amplifier. The Hall sensor is some sort of semiconducting material. Actually, there are two Hall elements that are positioned very close to each other. One of them reacts to the excitation on the vertical axis, and the other one to the horizontal axis. This sort of positioning eliminates the signal due to stress or the piezoresistance effect. Because the Hall voltage is a function of the current, we have to minimize the fluctuations as much as possible, and therefore we have the regulator in the input. To the output of the Hall element, we need to place an amplifier. This is because the Hall element provides only a few microvolts per gauss, 7 microvolts in silicon to be exact. Because we want to amplify only the differential potential between the two points, we use a differential amplifier. So far, we describe an analog Hall effect sensor that has analog output that is proportional to the input. The digital Hall effect sensor, on the other hand, can only be in two states, on or off, and this is achieved with a SCHMITT trigger. The SCHMITT trigger compares the output of the differential amplifier with a reference point. When the amplifier output exceeds this point, the SCHMITT trigger turns on, and when it falls below, the SCHMITT trigger turns off. Although we call it a sensor, the digital Hall effect sensor is mostly used as a non-contact switch, which kind of sums up our question from the beginning of the video. Can you press a switch without making physical contact? As an example, the first low-cost, high-volume application of the Hall sensor was in 1965 for truly solid-state keyboards. The Hall sensor made the keyboard chatter and bounce free. And reliable. Very reliable. 30 billion presses. Do they make computer mice like that? Anyways, the variety of applications grew more and more, and even though the Hall effect sensor is a magnetic field sensor, it can be used in other devices for temperature, pressure, positioning, current, and other measurements. Here we have a clamp meter, a device that can measure a current flow in a conductor without connecting it in series to the load. Not all of the clamp meters use a Hall effect sensor. For AC measurements, it is enough to use a transformer, which is cheaper. For more information about clamp meters, check our other video. Today, the Hall sensors are available in all shapes and colors. If we go to TMEU, we will find over 100 different Hall sensors for a wide range of operating temperatures, supply voltages, measuring ranges, and different types of cases. Well, that's it. If you have more questions, leave a comment, and if you like this video, like it. Thank you for watching.